Junior's coming down the track, coming down the track with a smoky stack. Hear him puffing, coming round the hill. Casey's here to thrill every Jack and Jill. Every time his funny little whistle sounds, everybody hurries to the circus ground. Time for lemonade and cracker jack. Casey Junior's back, Casey Junior's back.
Casey Junior is a little circus engine who lives at a big station on a railway company called the Fantasy and Fairy Tale Railway Traction Company Limited. He's a cheeky little engine with four small drive wheels, a little tender at the back, a big tall funnel, a little lamp hat, and a short stumpy boiler and a short stumpy dome with a whistle on top and a little cowcatcher in front. He's a fussy little engine too, always bringing coaches about ready for the other engines to take on long journeys. And when trains come in, he pulls the empty coaches away so that the other engines can go and rest. Casey Jr. doesn't think the other engines work as hard as he does. He loves playing tricks on them, including Montana, the biggest, proudest, and fastest engine of all. Casey Jr. likes whistling rudely at him.
Wake up, lazy bones. Why don't you work hard like me?
One day after pulling the big express, Montana had arrived back at the sidings very tired. He was just going to sleep when Casey Jr. came up in his cheeky way.
Wake up, lazy bones. Do some hard work for a change. You can't catch me.
And off he ran laughing. Instead of going to sleep again, Montana thought how he could get back at Casey Jr. Then one morning, Casey Jr. just wouldn't wake up. Landon and Emery couldn't make him start. His fire went out and there was not enough steam. And it was nearly time for the express. People were waiting, but the coaches weren't ready. At last, Casey Jr. started.
Oh dear.
He yawned. He fussed into the station where Montana was waiting.
Hurry up, you,
said Montana.
Hurry yourself,
replied Casey Jr. Montana began making his plan.
Yes,
said Montana.
I will.
And almost before the coaches had stopped moving, Montana reversed quickly and was coupled to the train.
Get in quickly, please,
he whistled. Casey Jr. usually pushed behind the big trains to help them start, but he was always uncoupled first. This time, Montana had started so quickly that they forgot to uncouple Casey Jr. Montana's chance had come.
Come on, come on,
puffed Montana to the coaches. The train was going faster and faster, too fast for Casey Jr. He wanted to stop, but he couldn't.
Wait, stop, stop.
Hurry,
laughed Montana. You can't get away, laughed the coaches. Poor Casey Jr. was going faster than he had ever gone before. He was out of breath, and his wheels hurting, but he had to go on.
I shall never be the same again,
he thought sadly.
My wheels will be fine for death.
Stop at a station. Casey Jr. was uncoupled and he felt very silly and exhausted. Next he went on to a turntable, thinking of everyone laughing at him. And then he went on to a siding out of the way.
Well, Casey Jr.,
chuckled Montana.
Now you know what hard work means, don't you?
Poor Casey Jr. couldn't answer. He had no breath. He just puffed slowly away to rest and had a long, long drink. He went home very slowly and was careful afterwards never to be cheeky to Montana again.
What bitch?